Hello everyone and welcome back to the Perfect French with Dylan. Today we are going to learn everything about two. Before we start, don't forget that you can grab the free PDF of this lesson. If you are on my mailing list, it's already in your inbox. I know that a lot of French learners struggle with two, and I understand why, because two can be an adjective, it can be an adverb, it can be a pronoun, and it can be a noun. It will sometimes agree in gender and number, and sometimes not. The pronunciation also changes depending if it's a pronoun or an adjective. But that's going to be for the end. First, let's see the different forms of to when it agrees in gender and number. Also, what does it mean to agree in gender and number? Well, you know that in French we have masculine singular, feminine singular, masculine plural, feminine plural. So depending on what to is attached to, it will change to masculine singular, feminine singular, etc., etc. We'll see everything about it, you will understand. So first, let's see the four different forms. We have tout, T-O-U-T, masculine singular, toute, feminine singular, with E at the end. The last letter that I pronounce is the T, not the E. And then we have tout, T-O-U-S, masculine plural. And then we have toutes, T-O-U-T-E-S, feminine plural. So the masculine are pronounced exactly the same. We have tout and tout. And then the feminine are pronounced exactly the same as well. We have toutes and toutes. So that was for the basic. We are going to start with tout as an adjective. As an adjective, we have two different types of tout. It's more two different translations for you in English. The first one will be all, and the second one will be any, every. Technically three, but let's keep it at two. So first, all. You will see, you know them already, it's not gonna be hard. We have toute la journée, toute la journée. So here, toute is feminine singular because journée is feminine singular. It means all day. Tu as travaillé toute la journée? Tu as travaillé toute la journée? Did you work all day? Technically, all the day. All the day, that's how we'll translate it. But toute la journée. We also have toute la nuit, all night. Same, nuit is feminine singular. Le chien a aboyé toute la nuit. Le chien a aboyé toute la nuit. And a plural this time, we have toutes les boîtes. Toutes les boîtes. So here, boîte is feminine plural, so tout is going to be feminine plural as well. So, toutes. And here, all the boxes. All the boxes. The translation checks this time. Les déménageurs ont emporté toutes les boîtes. Les déménageurs ont emporté toutes les boîtes. So that was for all. Now, any, every. Still an adjective. The first one, tous les jours. Tous les jours. Every day. So for you, it's singular, for us it's plural. Tous les jours. Je mange la même chose tous les jours. Je mange la même chose tous les jours. I eat the same thing every day. Another one. Toutes les semaines. Toutes les semaines. Every week. Il y a un nouveau podcast toutes les semaines. Il y a un nouveau podcast toutes les semaines. And tous les lundis. Tous les lundis. Every Monday. J'ai cours de piano tous les lundis. J'ai cours de piano tous les lundis. So for you, every Monday, for us, tous les lundis. If it's a repetitive thing, we are going to use tous les lundis. And here, we do not pronounce the S at tout when it's plural. We'll see, you will understand when we see it. Just remember that we do not pronounce it for tous les lundis, toutes les boîtes, etc., etc. For all, any, every, we do not pronounce the S at tout. Now, to as an adverb. If you remember the grammar course, when to is an adverb, it's not going to change, it's not going to agree in gender and number. So that helps a little bit. We have three different constructions with to as an adverb. The first one is to followed by another adverb. Let's see three. We have tout autant, just as much, il a tout autant de chance que toi. Il a tout autant de chance que toi. He is just as lucky as you are. So this is a way to just emphasize more what you want to say. Because you could just say, il a autant de chance que toi. But if you want to make a stronger statement, you can say, il a tout autant de chance que toi. Tout simplement. Tout simplement. Very simply. Il est tout simplement parti sans dire au revoir. Il est tout simplement parti sans dire au revoir. He simply left without saying goodbye. And the last one for this one, tout droit. Tout droit, straight ahead. Tout droit. Pour aller à la gare, allez tout droit. Pour aller à la gare, allez tout droit. To go to the train station, go straight ahead. Tout droit. So that was adverb plus adverb. Now, to followed by a preposition. You know how much I love preposition, so let's see. The first one is tout à fait. Tout à fait, absolutely. Tout à fait. Est-ce que c'est juste? Est-ce que c'est juste? Tout à fait. Tout à fait, absolutely. Next one. Tout de suite. Tout de suite. Tout de suite. If you say it fast, you don't say the E, add de. Tout de suite. J'arrive tout de suite. J'arrive tout de suite. Or, tout près de. Tout près de. On est tout près de l'aéroport. On est tout près de l'aéroport. We are close to the airport. So here, it also doesn't agree in gender and number. Now, we have to followed by an adjective. Not to as an adjective. We have to as an adverb, followed by an adjective. And here's the catch. It will not agree in gender and number if the following adjective starts with a voyelle or silent H. Let's see, you will understand. We have... Il est tout petit. Il est tout petit. He is very small. So that's masculine singular, so that's easy. But then if we look at the feminine one, elle est toute petite. Elle est toute petite. Toute is going to take a E and the pronunciation changes as well. Elle est toute petite. So we are good because the adjective starts with a consonant. Now let's see the same sentence, but with an adjective starting with a silent H. Silent H acting as a voyelle. So we can say, il est tout heureux, il est tout heureux, but elle est toute heureuse. Elle est toute heureuse. He's very happy, she's very happy. This is very particular, I even hesitated honestly to put it in the lesson, because this is very advanced. And I'm pretty sure if you ask 80% of French speaker or francophone, they don't know that rule. I can assure you. So if you know how to use that rule, good on you. Because, like I said, a lot of francophone don't know how to use it. That was the adverb. Now we are going to see it as a pronoun. First, let's see when it means all, everything. Then it's going to stay masculine only. It's not going to change. For example, tu sais toujours tout. Tu sais toujours tout. You always know everything. Okay, so everything here, tout. Tu sais toujours tout. Now, when it means all, everyone. Here, it's going to agree in gender and number, and we are going to have a pronunciation change. Let's see first the sentence with tout as an adjective, and then we're going to transform the sentence with tout as a pronoun. Tous les participants ont reçu un prix. Tous les participants ont reçu un prix. tous les participants. So this is the adjective. But if we take tous les participants and we change that into a pronoun, we are going to have tous ont reçu un prix. Tous ont reçu un prix. Here we pronounce the S. This is the only time when we are going to pronounce the S at tous. Only time. Tous ont reçu un prix. If we change the sentence as feminine, we'll have toutes les participantes ont reçu un prix. And here, if we change it with a pronoun, we have toutes ont reçu un prix. Toutes ont reçu un prix. So this one doesn't change from the adjective. It's only tous that is very particular. The masculine plural. Let's see another one. J'ai appelé tous mes amis. J'ai appelé tous mes amis. Tous mes amis is going to turn into the pronoun tous. Je les ai tous appelés. Je les ai tous appelés. But if we say toutes mes amies as a feminine, we have je les ai toutes appelées. Je les ai toutes appelées. Once again, the only time that tous is going to be pronounced as tous. The only time. Okay? Next one is when it's used as a noun. Then we are going to see a few expressions and that's it. So we're almost done. For a noun, it's always going to be masculine singular. It's le tout. Le tout. As, on va prendre le tout. On va prendre le tout. We will take the whole lot. I don't know how many times in your life you're going to use it, but here it is. Now a few expressions or at least group of words that you should remember. We have tout va bien. Tout va bien. Tout va bien. Tout d'un coup. Tout d'un coup, which can also be tout à coup, but tout d'un coup. Pas du tout, pas du tout. Tout le temps, tout le temps, tout le temps, but tout le temps, tout le temps. Tout le monde, tout le monde, tout le monde. Prendre tout son temps, prendre tout son temps. To take one sweet time, I like this one. Prendre tout son temps. En tout cas, en tout cas, avant tout, avant tout. This one is a whole sentence actually. C'est tout. C'est tout. That's all. C'est tout. And the last one. Tout est bien qui finit bien. Tout est bien qui finit bien. And I hope you think the same for this lesson. I hope I explained it very well for you. I hope that you are going to master the use of tout, tous, tout, etc, etc. It's not that hard really, but it requires a little bit of practice. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video, it really helped me. And I will see you on Friday for a short video. À vendredi!